Myself, Professor Pritish Chitte, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this fifth session, we will discuss feature-based modeling. In the last session, we have discussed what is meant by geometrical modeling, what are the different types of geometrical modeling, and the different schemes of solid modeling, that is constructive solid geometry and boundary representations. In this session, we will discuss the feature-based modeling. What are the learning outcomes? The students will be able to develop the different feature-based modeling. Means they can create the different 3D or 2D modeling. Also, they can create any 3D model with the help of different features of the modeling, that is the tools and the icons which are present inside the different modeling softwares of the different mechanical components. These are the contents. There are the different types of features based modeling. These are the 9 features we will discuss today. We will go through the first feature based modeling, that is padding. So this is the 3D view of the model. Before going to the 3D, we have to construct the 2D sketch. First, we have to create a rectangle for the particular, or maybe the square for the particular dimension, that is 200 by 200. Here we are providing the dimensions. And after that, we are creating the hexagon with the help of a profile toolbar in the sketch menu. After padding, this will be our 2D sketch. And after providing the padding feature, we can get a 3D model. So we have to provide the thickness here for the particular rectangle and the hexagon. This will be the 3D model after the padding feature. Pocketing. In the last feature, we have discussed the padding. What is meant by padding? Padding is actually the adding the material. Now, the second part, that will be the pocketing, where we have to remove the material from the particular surface. This is the earlier surface, that is the rectangle and the hexagon. Now, we have to provide the hole here. We can provide the hole with the help of the pocketing. 80 mm diameter circle we have created here. After that, we have to just provide the depth of cut, that is the throughout. This will be our 2D sketch, which will be required for the pocketing. And whenever we are entering into the 3D tool or the 3D view, there will be the pocketing tool inside the sketch base feature, and we can create the pocketing or the hole here. So this will be the sketch for the pocketing, and this will be the 3D model after the pocketing. Here we are subtracting the material, or we are removing the material from the surface. Shaft here, before going to the 3D shaft, we have to create some 2D sketch here. Here we are creating some rectangles here, side to the axis here. This will be the another rectangle, this will be the another rectangle by some dimensions. And after providing the shaft tool with respect to this axis, we can create this shaft. So this will be the 360 degree rotation by creating this, or by rotating this rectangle in the circular base by 360 degree, you can create the different shaft. This will be act as a cylinder. This is the solid shaft. So this will be the sketch for the shaft here. This is the 2D sketch. And after rotating by this axis by 360 degree, you can get the 3D model after shaft. Hole. Here, we got this actually the rectangle, or maybe the padding surface already. After that, we want to create some hole here on this surface. So here, this is the hole. Suppose you want to create the hole, this will be the view in the 3D view. So this will be the 25 mm diameter. That is the throughout, that is up to next surface. You have to provide the particular coordinate, or maybe the sketch, at which point or the coordinate you have to provide the hole. So this will be the point. And 20 mm diameter hole we want to create by throughout. So you can get with the help of this hole definitions tool. And this will be your a particular hole, this one. So hole on the 3D surface. Now, just think about this. What is the difference between the pad and the pocket? Think about this. We are just discuss this. Now, what are the different types of holes? Now here, you can create the throughout hole just we have discussed here. The drill hole that is called as the peg drilling. The milled hole you can also create. Suppose we are having some material and after that we have to provide some hole here. Right, we can do it. Counter bore, you can provide inside the, there are the different features in the drill or maybe the hole operation. Rectangular slot you can also create inside the hole surfaces. The T slot, the last one will be the T slot. Countersunk also you can provide with the help of the hole command or the hole tool. These are the different types of holes. Rib tool or the rib feature based modeling. So this is the sketch you have to create. Suppose this is the one vertical surface you are having, after that the horizontal surface you are having, and you want the rib here at this surface at the midsection. You have to create some triangle here, right? Here you have to use the 3D projection. You have to use the 3D projection for creating these two lines, the two yellow lines. After that you have to just create this line, and after that whenever you are selecting on the rib section in the 3D view, you can get the rib 3D on side this vertical and the horizontal surface. So this will be the sketch for the rib and this will be the 3D model for the after the rib section. Now the chamfer and the fillet feature. Now suppose this is a rectangle and after that you have to provide the chamfer. So you can provide this chamfer here, this one. Also you can chamfer means that will be the edge, the slope surface will be there. After that the filleting part, you can provide the filleting to the different types of edges. That will be the circular fillet, you can call this, you can call the circular filleting. So this will be a 3D view, this will be the chamfering, and this will be the different filleting surfaces. Loft. So here suppose on one plane you have created one circle and on the another plane you have created one rectangle. By multi-section solid you can join these, a circle and the rectangle at one time, and resulting will be the different types of model. For example, our monitors, suppose you want to create the model of the monitor, you can use the loft section or the multi-section solids. For the different types of, suppose the one surface is of one geometrical entity, for example the circle, or maybe we are having the rectangle to the another side. So you can create these surfaces, the different surfaces, with the help of multi-section solid, which is called as 3D loft. Shell is similar to the pocketing, but here we are providing the thickness between the surfaces. This is the rectangular shell. Suppose you are having the one cube and you have to provide the here, the shell here. So you can create, you can use this surface, you can select the surface, and after that you can select the another surface that will be the supporting surface, and you can have the, we can call it as the pocketing. We can remove this particular surface providing some thickness here, right? So this will be the rectangular surface. Suppose you are having the solid cylinder and you want to provide some shelling part here, you have to remove some material providing some thickness. After that, this is called as the hollow pipe. You can use the circular shell inside the cutia, right? This is the rectangular shell and this will be the a circular shell. The last point, spring. First you have to create one simple a helical part here in the 2D sketch here, like this. After that take one plane, and after that on that plane here, on this point, you can have to create one circle, and with the help of spring command or maybe the multi-section solid command, you can create a 3D spring. Very easily you can create the 3D spring inside the cutia. Now the use of the features, like suppose you want to create any a different mechanical component, the model of a mechanical component, you can use this pad, pocket, or maybe the shaft, or maybe the loft, multi-section solids. So we will go directly to the different softwares, like we are using the CATIA software here. So we'll go to the direct CATIA software and we will practice some sessions. Now here, suppose we will take some simple rectangle here, right? And suppose you want to provide the dimension. In the profile toolbar, we can take the rectangle here, and after that, give the dimension. Here we can give the dimension with the help of constraint command. First dimension, second dimension, exit workbench. So this will be out of 2D sketch. This will be our 3D view, part design view. After that, go to the pocket. So this is the tool for the pocket, that is sketch based feature. Go to the padding command. Here we have to add the material. So I will select 100 mm, that is the thickness, and go to the preview first, and okay. After that, suppose you want to provide here the pocket part. Suppose you want to remove the surface here. We have add the material, now we have to remove the surface. Now I will select on this surface, go to the sketch, now create simple circle here, anywhere, give the dimension 60 mm, okay. After that, exit workbench. Here there is a point which is called as pocket. Now type throughout up to the next preview. Okay, you can see this is the throughout hole which we can do with the help of pocketing. Now we'll move to the, these are the references.